Welcome to the course on game theory in the autumn term 2020 at the University of Mannheim. This is the fourth video of week four. In theorem 3.3, we have seen that the mixed extension of any finite game in normal form has Nash equilibria. This was an important result of John Nash, and we have seen two proofs of it. One used the fixed point theorem of Kakutani, and the other older one used the fixed point theorem of Brouwer. So now we have existence of Nash equilibria in this situation, and the next question, at least for mathematicians, should be, and now, what more do we know about these sets of Nash equilibria? For any such game, this is a non-empty set, but how large it is, what does it look like, and how one can control it. What are typical properties? So these are some research questions, and there has been work on them, but not that much. I was myself surprised that there has not been so much work on it. And in this long subsection 3.4, I will go a few steps into this direction. So this is a subsection about the geometry of the sets of Nash equilibria in mixed extensions of finite games. So it starts with a long definition where I present some important notions. We will need them in order to formulate the geometry in an also long theorem. And the theorem and the definitions will be illustrated by three rather long examples. So, and one aim, but not the only one, one aim is to prove, for example, that in the case of a finite two-person game, the set of Nash equilibria is a union of polytopes. A polytope was a compact convex set, which is a convex hull of a finite set of points in the real finite dimension vector space. So in the two-person game, the set of Nash equilibria is a union of such polytopes. The polytopes may have different dimensions and their union is usually not convex, but still it's a quite, in some sense, it has an easy geometry. There is no curvature. It's piecewise a fine linear and determined by linear inequalities locally. So this is one of the results of this long theorem, and in fact it's the last part. So the examples will illustrate this theorem in some typical cases. So let's start with the notations. I start very slowly with some very classical notations. These are some notions from a course on analysis. So I consider R up to n for some natural number n, some epsilon bigger 0, and some point x0 in up to n. And the ball of radius epsilon around x0 is given by b epsilon of x0, and you know how it's defined. Just look at the definition. So all points in x in up to n whose distance is smaller than, from x0 is smaller than epsilon, and the distance is defined, the norm of such a vector x is defined by this square root of the sum of its coordinates, of this sum of the square of the coordinates. This is very well known. So in for some arbitrary subset A in R up to n, the interior of A is defined here. It's denoted by an upper index 0, so it's not a power, it's an upper index 0. It consists of those points in x such that it contains also a ball around these points. And in fact, the interior of A is the largest open subset of Rn, which is contained in A. So for any subset A, one can also consider the closure of A in R up to n. It's in the last line here. It consists of all points at x in R up to n, such that they contain arbitrary small neighborhoods of them contain points of A. So for any epsilon, the ball around x of order of radius epsilon intersects the set A non-emptily. So especially A itself is contained in its closure, but also some, it might contain other points. And in fact, this closure is the smallest closed subset of R up to n, which contains A. Now we have seen the interior is the largest subset of A, which is open. The closure is the smallest set which contains A, which is closed. So these are dual constructions. And in fact, there is a small lemma, which I will not prove now. The closure of A is the complement of the interior of the complement of A. And the interior of A is the complement of the closure of the complement of A. So because these are really dual constructions here. So this is quite classical. The next step is now already, we go back to game theory. So we look again at the finite game ASU and its mixed extension AGV. And now I define three maps for each player I, delta I, alpha I, and beta I in the following way. So delta I is a certain correspondence. Its domain of definition is the set of mixed strategy combinations of the other players, G minus I, and the values are subsets of SI, so a subset of the set of pure strategies of player I, so with a certain correspondence. And in fact, it's close to the only correspondence which we had up to now. That was the set of best replies. Delta I of G minus I is the set of pure best replies. It is a set of those best replies which are pure strategies of player I. So it's intersection of SI with the set of all mixed best replies. So delta I of G minus I is the set of pure best replies of player I to the mixed strategy combination G minus I of the other players. So alpha I has as definition of domain the finite subsets, the set of finite subsets of the set of pure strategies of player I, except for the empty set, that's not interesting. So in the image is a subset, is a set of subsets of G minus I. And similarly, beta I has the same domain of definition and also the same image space. So in alpha I, for now consider some subset AI of the set SI of pure strategies of player I. So AI is a finite set, it is a subset of the set of all pure strategies of player I. And now the image set alpha I of AI consists of all those mixed strategy combinations of the other players, such that their set of pure best replies is exactly AI. So the image of AI under alpha I consists of those mixed strategy combinations of the other players, such that their pure best replies, this pure best reply set is exactly the set AI. In the case beta I, the image consists of all those mixed strategy combinations of the other players, such that the set of pure best replies contains AI. So now, first discussion before we prove anything. The set delta I of G minus I of pure best replies is not empty because the set of mixed best replies is not empty because all the sets here are compact and the utility functions are continuous. And because of lemma 39b, equivalence 1, there we had seen that if you have some mixed strategy gi, which is the best reply to g minus I, then also all the pure strategies in its support are pure best replies to g minus I. So, and because this set I of g minus I is not empty, we have at least one mixed strategy gi, which is a best reply to g minus I, and then also it's also the pure strategies in its support are also best replies. So therefore this set delta I of G minus I is not empty. But these sets alpha I of AI and beta I of AI, they might be empty, they can well be empty. In the examples you will see it. And obviously alpha I of AI is a subset of beta I of AI. This is immediate from the definition of these two sets. So now it will pay off to use some efficient coordinates on the set GI of mixed strategies of player I. So recall that we did already enumerate the pure strategies of player I, SI1 to SINI. Then any mixed strategy GI is a convex combination of the pure strategies with coefficients gamma ij in between 0 and 1, and the sum of all these coefficients is equal to 1, because GI is a convex combination. That means that we can rewrite the last coefficient, gamma INI, as 1 minus the sum of the other coefficients. So in a sense, this gamma INI as a coordinate is superfluous, because we are on this hyperplane where the sum of all these coefficients is 1, we can drop the last coefficient. The other already will form a coordinate system. So gamma I1 to gamma INI minus 1 together can be used as a coordinate system on this set GI of mixed strategies of player I. So one can identify GI with the set of all tuples gamma I1 to gamma INI minus 1 such that each of the entry is non-negative and such that the sum of these entries is less or equal to 1. Then the difference of 1 minus the sum will be the last coefficient gamma I and I. And that will then also be, and also automatically we see that these conditions together they imply that this gamma ij is in 0, 1. And also gamma I and I is in 0, 1. That's clear. So here are some pictures. If ni is equal to 2, we can drop gamma I2 and live with gamma I1 alone, because then GI is just this interval from 0 to 1. In the case ni equals 3, GI is a triangle and it's so part of a surface. So there the coefficients, the coordinates gamma I1 and gamma I2 are sufficient, and we see how which values they have. So then any strategy there can be identified with a pair of real numbers between 0 and 1. And the first pure strategy has then coordinates 1, 0, the second one has coordinates 0, 1, and the third one has coordinates 0, 0. There gamma I3 is equal to 1, but gamma I3 here is not part of the coordinate system. So now using this coordinate system, we can write our utility function in a useful way. So the utility function UI was VI was a restriction of VIW on the vector space W. So in VIW for any player K was multilinear, so it is linear in gamma K1 to gamma KNK. So the map was multilinear, and for each player it was linear in the coefficients of this player. And now the last coefficient, gamma k and k, will be replaced by 1 minus the sum of the other coefficients. And then we can rewrite our homogeneous polynomial we can reorder all these monomials and order them by gamma I1 to gamma I and I minus 1. And this gives us some polynomials, kappa I and lambda ij, or polynomial functions on G minus I. So that the following holds. Here then the whole utility function VI of G takes in the shape kappa I of G minus I plus the sum of lambda ij of G minus I times gamma ij. So before it was linear in the coefficients gamma I1 to gamma I and I, but now as I replace gamma I and I by the 1 minus the sum of the others, it now is affine linear. So this is the one which we have here. So if we write now gamma I and I as 1 minus the sum over j equivalent to n I minus 1 gamma I j, then the one here takes care that now the utility function becomes some affine linear function. So a sum of something which is linear, here this is linear in the gamma ij, and something constant which is here, constant with respect to the coefficients of player I. So, and yeah, now we can define additionally also this is a definition of lambda ij, implicit definition here. We can also define lambda I and I as zero, that will make sense, as a constant function with value zero on g minus I. And we can define the function lambda I max on g minus I with real values, which is the maximum of all these functions lambda a ij for j from 1 to n I. So here, including this trivial function equal zero. Here's one example how it looks concretely. So you remember the first line of this example from example 3.4. Now in this, from the first to the second line, I have replaced gamma 2.3 here by 1 minus gamma 2.1 minus gamma 2.2. And also here I've replaced it. Minus sign. And here I've replaced gamma 1.3 by, you can't see it, it's there somewhere, by 1 minus gamma 1.1 minus gamma 1.2. So in the next line I just simplify. Here I have minus gamma 2.2 minus gamma 2.2, and here is another minus gamma 2.2 times gamma 1.1. Now, first I take the constant part. Here is a, on the right where you can see it, is a 1 minus gamma 1.1 minus gamma 1.2. And this 1 gives us this term here in the front. So for the player 1, that's a constant term. Okay, and what is the coefficient of gamma 1.1 now? It is here minus gamma 2.2 minus gamma 2.2. Here is another minus gamma 2.2 from gamma 1.2 here. So minus 3 gamma 2.2. Then the 1 comes to this place, and gamma 2.1, here gamma 2.1, this is raises with, drops, is cancelled with this gamma 2.1, because it inherits a plus sign from minus gamma 1.1 on the right. So we come to this term. And then similarly here for gamma 1.2, the coefficient is first gamma 1.2 plus gamma 1.2, and here also gamma 1.2 plus 3 times gamma 1.2, then minus 1, minus 1. And gamma 2.2 here cancels with the gamma 2.2 here, because here f on the right f minus gamma 1.2. So at the end I come to this line here. Now we clean this up, this mess. So now we are in the third line here. And yeah, this can now, you can see clearly what is kappa 1 and what is the lambda 1 here and what is lambda 1.1 and lambda 1.2. So these coefficients kappa 1 and lambda 1.1 and lambda 1.2 here are themselves affine linear functions in the coordinates of the other players. And here it's just one other player. And so in V2 can be calculated in a similar way by exchanging the coordinates of player 1 and player 2. And so I do not want to continue this example now. I will continue this later. This will be example 3.14. So there we will make use of the calculation which we just have done. I do want to continue with this video. I want to go now into the first part of the theorem. I want to discuss still the parts A, B, and C. So now we come to the results. And first, some general, quite easy results. So again, we have a finite game ASU and a mixed extension AGV. And in most of the theorem, I will fix one player I. So part A, for any mixed strategy combination of the other players G minus I, the set of mixed best replies Ri of G minus I is the convex hull of the set of pure best replies. So we had to find the set of pure best replies as intersection of the set of mixed best replies with the set of pure strategies. And now we have some, something additional. We can say we could construct the set of pure best replies from the set of mixed best replies. And now we see the inverse. We can also construct the set of mixed best replies by the set of pure best replies. Namely, it's just the convex hull. And I do want to go right into the proof of this statement. And we have to recall something from lemma 3.9 for this. So now I go down in the script to the proof of this part A. Here. So the utility value Vi of G for any mixed strategy combination G can be written by the linearity of Vi for the entries of the ith player as such a sum that you see here on the right hand side. So a pure strategy Sij is a pure best answer if the value of the utility function here is maximal within all possible values of the utility function on Gi here. So above we have some concrete formula for this Vij, and one sees that this function here takes a maximal value if and only if it is a linear combination of only maximal terms here. So it can be maximal only if all these coefficients here are maximal, because here we can only distribute something which sums up to one. So and therefore the set of mixed best replies corresponds to those tuples of coefficients, of convex coefficients, such that all the coefficients vanish for whom the pure strategy Sij is not a pure best answer. So Sij is not a pure best answer if the corresponding value here is not the maximal one. And in that case, here upstairs, gamma ij must be zero, else the sum would be smaller than possible. But if the value Vi of this Sij is maximal, then we can put some weight on this value, and this will not change the maximal value. So the set of mixed best replies consists of all those tuples of coefficients here, such that the coefficients for pure best replies are arbitrary, and the coefficients for pure non-best replies have to be zero. So and this is exactly the convex hull of the set of pure best replies. So this was part A. I have to go back now to the theorem. So part B, the concrete description of these maps delta I, alpha I, and beta I. So delta I of G minus I is the set of pure best replies of G minus I. So the set of those pure strategies of player I such that Vi of Sij G minus I is the maximal possible value. And I'm sorry, I have to go again into the proof. So you see what I want to prove it is that a pure strategy Sij is the best reply if and only if this equality holds here. And for that, I again go down to the proof of this part B. Not too far. Here. So I fix some mixed strategy combination G minus I of the other players. And I want to give a new characterization of those pure strategies which are pure best replies. And these are those which maximize this utility function, which give the, have the maximum value. So now we have these formulas for utility function, which you see here. We have the formulas for these values, which you see here and here, these coefficients. So and now I have to ask, which choices of these gamma ij give me the maximal value for vij? So I have already almost the same consideration was done in the proof of part A. So the mixed best replies are precisely all those combinations of these coefficients gamma ij, such that all those maybe non-empty, where we have the maximal coefficient, how did I write it? Now that was written a different way. So here, all those coefficients here, which if some lambda ij is maximal with respect to all, is equal to lambda I max, so it's the maximal one, then I am free to give it some weight gamma ij. If some coefficient is not the maximal one, then I have to give it the coefficient zero here. Because if it's not maximal, then I shouldn't put weight on it because it would decrease the whole value. So I consider this gamma ij as some weights. I can distribute altogether the weight 1 to my coefficients. And so I have to be careful and cautious, and I may put my weights to those lambda ij, which are the maximal possible lambda I max. And the others have to get weight 0. So this tells me that the pure best replies are those strategies Sij such that lambda ij is equal to lambda I max. That is what I wanted to prove. So now I go back. That was the main part of this part B here. Yep. So the pure best replies are those pure strategies Sij such that their coefficient lambda ij is the maximal possible one, is equal to lambda I max. And from this is now easy to derive the concrete descriptions of alpha I and beta I. Alpha I of AI. So AI is now a fixed subset of the set of pure strategies. And alpha I of AI consists of those mixed strategy combinations G minus I, such that AI is a set of pure best replies to J minus I. Yeah, but for any G minus I, the set of pure best replies consists of those strategies which satisfy this equality here. So G minus I is a mixed strategy combination of the other players whose set of best replies is equal to AI, if and only if for all Sij and AI, we have this equality holds. And for all other strategies, they must be not best replies. They have to be not best replies. We need an inequality. This must be smaller. I don't want them in, they are not in AI, so they have to have, their coefficient must be smaller. So this here implies in the description of alpha I. And similarly, it gives also the description of beta I. Beta I consists of AI consists of all mixed strategy combinations of the other players, such that the set of pure best replies contains AI. So all pure strategies in AI are best replies. That gives me this equality here. And the others might be best replies or might be not best replies. That gives me essentially nothing, but this is a trivial here, trivial inequality. Because lambda I max is maximal, this says nothing. I mean, I can also drop this. I could drop this line, it's not important here. It's not wrong, but it says nothing. So this gives me also the concrete descriptions of these two sets, alpha I of AI and beta I of AI. But recall that they may both be empty. Delta I of G minus I is never empty. So and the last part which I want to discuss in this video is now part C. For any finite subset AI of SI which is not empty, beta I of AI is closed. So we have seen it contains, of course, alpha I by definition, but then it contains also the closure of alpha I, because of course the closure of alpha is the smallest closed set which contains alpha I of AI. But still, beta I of AI may be empty or not. We don't know. So and beta I of AI is closed because we have here only non-strict inequalities in this description. So the values lambda ij can now be considered as continuous functions on the space g minus I. And then beta I of AI is given by here this set of equalities and non-strict inequalities for the g minus I, for these functions in the g minus I. So, and because the inequalities are non-strict, beta I of AI is a closed subset. And that proves part C here. And here I want to stop the video. Thank you very much.